Hello friends, welcome to YouTube channel Electronics. Today we will discuss about transistors and SMD transistors coding schemes. First we will start with power rating of transistors. TO series transistor packages are varied according to their power ratings and applications. TO stands for transistor outline. Low power transistor package is made of plastic material and smaller in size, while transistors with high power usually made of metal or mixture of plastic and metal, and they are bigger in size. We will discuss them one by one. First, we will start with TO92 package. The TO92 is a widely used transistor package. The case is made of plastic and offers compact size at very low cost. The pin configuration of 2N series, 2S series and BC series transistors are specified here. TO92 devices are mainly used in low power applications up to 600 milliwatts. Next one, TO18 transistor package. TO18 is a metal can package. TO39 also looks like TO18 package, but slightly bigger in size. Terminal identification is specified here. The collector is internally connected to the case. TO18 package transistors are expensive than similarly sized plastic TO92 package transistors. Besides this, by placing cylindrical heat sinks like this, we can avoid too much heating. So, maximum power rating of TO18 transistors are up to 1200 milliwatts and TO39 transistors are up to 10 watts. Next one, TO220 and TO247 package transistors. These package transistors are used in high powered applications. The pin configuration is specified here. By placing them on bigger heat sinks like this, we can dissipate several watts of waste heat. Remember, we must use heat sink compound, screw bushings and insulation pad before placing heatsink on a transistor, because the contact between heatsink and transistor must be thermally conductive but electrically insulative. Next one, TO3 package transistors. TO3 is a type of metal can package that is capable of high power dissipation, commonly named as power transistors. The pin configuration is specified here. The collector is attached to the metal body to dissipate heat faster. The flat surface of the case can be attached to a heat sink. Next one, SOT-23 package. SOT stands for small outline transistors. These are very small in size and widely used in consumer electronics. Because of the package size, these transistors are low power devices. The pin configuration of SOT-23 transistor are specified here. Next one, SOT-223 package transistors. The pin configuration is specified here. There are generally four terminals, one of which is a large heat transfer pad. The collector is internally attached to this large pad. This enables heat to be transferred to the PCB. The SOT-223 package is a power surface mount transistor. Here we can see the physical size of various package transistors. We may say that the size of the transistors describes its power handling capability. Transistor specifications can be identified by the alphanumeric codes printed on their surface. There are four international standard coding schemes used for transistor marking. If you understand the coding schemes, you can select the best for a particular circuit. First one, EIA standard coding scheme. This numbering scheme was originated in the United States of America. Second one, JIS standard scheme. This standard was developed in Japan. Third one, Pro-Electron numbering system. This system was originated in Europe. And the fourth one, manufacturer's coding scheme. Manufacturers use their own part numbering scheme. Let's discuss these four coding schemes one by one. The standardized EIA 370 system introduced by EIA in the United States. This coding scheme is widely used for diodes and transistors that are originated from the US. Transistors coding start with 2N. For example, 2N 4 times 2 a transistor. In this coding scheme, first digit is always represented with a single digit number. Here it is 2. The second digit always represented with letter N. Next 3 or 4 digits represents its serial number. Here it is 4 times 2. And the last digit is a optional suffix format. Here it is A. Let's see what is this code 2N 4 times 2 A indicates. First digit is a number. This number represents number of PN junctions in the semiconductor device. So 1 for diodes, 2 for transistors, 3 for dual gate FETs, 4 and 5 for optocouplers. And second digit is always N. Next 3 or 4 digits represents device serial number. The serial number runs from 100 to 9999. We can use this serial number to identify its approximate time of introduction. And the last digit is an optional suffix. Indicates the gain or HFE group of the device. A indicates low gain, B for medium gain, C for high gain. If no suffix, it is ungrouped, may have any gain. The reason for this gain grouping is that the low gain devices are cheaper than high gain devices, resulting in cost saving for high volume users. Some more examples of EIA coded transistors are 2N3819 and 2N904. Second type of coding scheme is Japanese Industrial Standards Part Numbering Scheme. All transistors designation starts with 2S series. For example, 2SC828AQ transistor. Like EIA coding, here also first digit is represented with a single digit number. Indicates number of PN junctions in the device. Here it is 2. Next 2 digits represented with alphabet letters, which indicates type and application. Next 2 to 4 digits indicates device serial number, like 828 here. Following the serial number, a suffix can be used to indicate the device has been approved for particular usage, like here AQ. Let's see what is this code 2SC828AQ indicates. First digit is a number 2. This number represents number of PN junctions in the semiconductor device. So 1 for diodes, 2 for transistors and 3 for dual gate FETs. Next 2 digits represented with alphabet letters. They indicate the type of semiconductor material used and area of application of the device. Like here, SC represents it is a NPN transistor, can be used in high frequency applications. Since the code for transistors always begins with 2S, it is sometimes omitted. For example, 2SC828AQ would be marked as C828AQ. Next 2 to 4 digits represents device serial number. The serial number runs between 10 to 9999. The last 2 digits are optional suffix format. Indicates device has been approved for particular usage. Let's go into the details of this suffix. The first letter in the suffix represents variants of the device. Here A indicates the later version than the original. Multiple versions are possible for some devices. They can be with suffixes B, C and etc. If we go into the data sheet of this transistor 2SC828A, here it is given. If we enlarge this section for clear view, the difference is summarized here. Transistor with suffix A have improved maximum voltage rating than the original. The general rule is that you can safely replace earlier suffix letter device with a later one. For example, we can replace 2SC828 with 2SC828A, but not vice versa. Last suffix letter indicates that there are different ranges of HFE values of the transistor. HFE is nothing but DC current gain. If you go into the data sheet of this transistor 2SC828A, here it is given. If we enlarge this section for clear view, the DC current gain group is summarized here. If the last digit in suffix is Q, then transistor has HFE range between 130 to 280. If R, HFE is 180 to 360. If S, HFE is 260 to 520. And if there is no such suffix letter, then HFE range will be in between this minimum value 130 and maximum value 520. Some more examples of JIS coded transistors are 2SA1187 and 2SC733. The third type of coding scheme is Pro-Electron or EECA, European Electronic Component Manufacturers Association coding scheme. One example of European standard coding transistor is BC108A. In this scheme, first digit is an alphabet letter. It indicates the type of semiconductor material used to manufacture the device. Here it is B. Second digit is also alphabet letter. It indicates device's area of application. Here it is C. Next, 3 or 4 digits indicates device serial number, like 108 here. Last digit is an optional suffix. It indicates device gain grouping. Here it is A. Let's see what is this code BC108A indicates. First digit is an alphabet letter. This letter indicates type of semiconductor material used in this device. They are listed in this table. Here it is B, means this transistor made of silicon semiconductor. Next digit is also an alphabet letter. Indicates the device area of application. They are listed in this table. Here it is C, means this transistor can be used in audio frequency low power applications. Next 3 or 4 digits indicates device serial number. This serial number runs from 100 to 9999. If all the digits are numbers like here, then this transistor is made for domestic purposes. For example, if the transistor is coded as BF551, here Y51 represents device serial number. For those transistors whose serial number have a letter followed by two numbers, the transistors are intended to use in commercial or industrial purposes. Commercial or industrial use transistor serial number is in between A10 to Z99. So BC108A is a low power audio transistor for domestic use, and BF551 is a HF low power transistor for industrial use. On some cases, there may be a suffix alpha alphabet letter after serial number. This suffix letter indicates gain level of the transistor listed in this table. Here it is A, means this transistor have a low gain. This gain grouping is very useful for manufacturers as well as users, because when the transistors are manufactured, there is a large spread in the gain levels. They can be stored and marked according to their gain. Some examples of European coded transistors are BAW68 and BF239. The last type of numbering scheme is manufacturer's numbering scheme. Some manufacturers wanted to produce devices that were unique to them. In some areas, it would provide a device with a unique selling point that other manufacturers could not copy. Some common examples are Motorola, Texas Instruments, and etc. We can identify Motorola transistors with starting 2 or 3 alphabet letters that starts with M, listed in this table. MJ represents Motorola's power transistor with metal case. MJE represents Motorola's power transistor with plastic case. We have already discussed the package types, their power ratings, and area of application, so that might be somewhat helpful. The code printed on Motorola transistor describes its device code, year of manufacturing, and country code. By using this device code MJ2955, we can download datasheet from the manufacturer's website to know the full specification. Texas Instruments transistors coded like TIP, TIPL, and TIS. Their package styles shown here. We must visit manufacturer's website with part number to know the specifications. Ferranti transistors are coded with ZT and ZTX. RCA transistors are coded with RCA and RCS. Here also, we must visit manufacturer's websites to know the specifications. SMD transistors are very tiny to carry conventional numbering codes, so the device packages carries a simple 2 or 3 characters ID code. To identify particular SMD device, first identify the package type and note the ID code printed on the device. Now visit this S manuals website to know the device specifications. This link is also given in the description. You can visit from there. I have already made a video of how to identify SMD devices coding scheme. That video link also provided in the description. Do watch that video for how to decode SMD codes or how to get or use data sheets for SMD devices. I am also providing link for the SMD code HTML book. This link is also given in the description. You can download and save this book for reference from Google Drive. That's all about transistors coding scheme. If you have learned from this video, please do mention them in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please click the like button. Help others to learn by sharing this video. Please subscribe and turn on notifications for more such videos. Have a nice day.